Dear student, today we are going to learn about reproductive system of hen. The reproductive system of hen consists of ovary and oviducts. The birds reproduce through an egg. It means they are oviparous. At the time of early embryonic development, you'll find the two ovaries and oviducts. But the right side of the ovary and oviduct get atrophied under the influence of Mullerian inhibiting substance or the Mullerian inhibiting hormone. And at the time of hatching, only the left ovary and oviduct remain functional. The ovary, it comprises of yolk, stalk and the ovarian follicle, whereas oviducts have different parts like infundibulum, magnum, isthmus, uterus and the vagina. So the first part is the infundibulum. It is around 8 to 10 centimeter in length, and major function of the infundibulum is the site of fertilization. It is the funnel like structure. It captures the ovum, or we call it as the yolk, from the ovary, and the developing egg stays around 20 minutes in the infundibulum. Second part is the magnum. It is the largest part of the oviduct. It is around 33 centimeter in length, and the major function is the secretion of the white or the albumin, and the developing egg stays around 3 hours in the magnum. Next part is the isthmus. It is the narrow portion. It is around 10 to 11 centimeter in length, and the major function is the addition of the shell membranes or the formation of the shell membranes. It also adds water and the minerals to the developing egg, and the egg, developing egg, stays around 1 hour 30 minutes in isthmus. And the next portion is the uterus. It's also known as shell gland, where the major function is the formation of the shell and the pigments. It is around 10 centimeter in length, and the developing egg stays around 18 to 21 hours in the uterus. And the last part is the vagina, and the major function is to hold the eggs until it is laid. It is the portion where the egg turns, and you will find the birds will lay broad in first. That is oviposition. At the time of oviposition, you will get the broad end first, and the rotation occurs in the vagina. So coming to the summary, only in case of birds, the left ovary and oviduct remain functional. Magnum, it is the largest portion of the oviduct, and the ovulation occurs within 30 to 45 minutes after the oviposition or the laying. These are the